Thank you all for the nice presentation, and I'm very happy to be with you in this evening to share our experience about non-invasive assessment of the liver fibrosis, and I will cover in this evening the shear wave elastography method. And in our daily practice, we have a lot of patients with different liver diseases, and this start in previous time, especially with chronic B or C hepatitis. But now we have an epidemic of fatty liver. We have two autoimmune liver diseases and other diseases. Don't forget alcoholic steatohepatitis. And the assessment of this chronic liver disease can be performed by invasive methods like liver biopsy that we perform a lot, thousand in the previous time, or we can have evaluation of such patient by non-invasive modality of evaluation. And we have here biological test or elastographic method. In the last 10 years, the number of liver biopsy decreased everywhere in the world, especially in Europe, because now the need for liver biopsy in chronic B or C hepatitis is decreasing, and for liver and for fatty liver, the number of such investigation is not able to be very, very high. I like to show you one criticism for liver biopsy. And this is a systematic review in more than 8,000 subjects where we can see the major and minor complication can appear till 6% of cases. But what is maybe most important is the specimen that we obtain that is not the best that we like to have one. And in this meta-systematic review, only 42% of liver biopsy performed with large needle contain 10 or more portal tracts that are enough good for a very correct diagnostic, morphological diagnosis. Then I like to offer something that is quite simple from my point of view. It's now implemented in our daily activity, and this is ultrasound-based liver elastography. I don't like to speak nothing about MR elastography because it's a different topic, because I will be focused today only on ultrasound-based liver elastography. And the first EFSUMB guideline that was published in 2013 divide this elastography in shear wave elastography and strain elastography. The shear wave elastography can be divided in transient elastography, in point shear wave elastography, and the real time or 2D shear wave elastography. And the other is strain elastography that I will speak a little about this one. How to use both of these? Strain elastography is used mainly for evaluation of breast nodule and maybe for other purposes like thyroid or muscle or other structure. While shear wave elastography is mainly used for liver stiffness evaluation. Which is the advantage of shear wave elastography? The probe produces the shear wave elastography. We don't need to have any push like in strain. We push only a button and we have the result immediately expressed in kilopascal. This was the first unit that was used by in FibroScan. Or we can have it meter per second, how the American like, or we can have quite for all machine now expressing both kilopascal and meter per second. Learning curve is not very long. Usually 50 examination is enough to have some experience. Maybe for 2D shear wave elastography, some ultrasound experience necessary to find the best place for evaluation. I will start with transient elastography. This is well known because it's used in practice maybe for more than 10 years, and there are a lot of published paper showing the good value. And this paper was, this research was made in comparison with liver biopsy like reference method. There are some facts. The correlation between transient elastography and fibrosis increase with the severity of the fibrosis being higher in the thyroid liver. Transient elastography can be performed by doctor or by technician, like in some country, like in France. It's easy to be learned. And in this moment, we have thousand of scientific paper behind this method, and this showed a very good accuracy for all type of liver diseases. First published paper was about ACV, later on HBV, but there are many other papers for NAFLD or NASH, ASH, or cholestatic or autoimmune diseases. Then we have for all these diseases enough paper behind. Well-known FibroScan, we have two probe, M probe for normal people and XL probe for obese people. We have in the same screen the value of fibrosis expressed in kilopascal and the value of CAP evaluation of steatosis in decibel per meter, easy to be used by everyone. We have some cutoff value for significant fibrosis 2 or more. And we have here this cutoff for fibrosis 2 is somewhere around 7 kilopascal for all the diseases, HBV infection, NAFLD, or primary biliary cholangitis. And the AUROC is quite high, between 0.81 and 0.92. Looking for diagnosis of cirrhosis, here the value of FibroScan is increasing, and here the sensitivity of transient elastography is 87, and especially more than 90. And in two meta-analyses, we have the cutoff value for cirrhosis, 13 kilopascal in ACV patient, with this AUROC 0.94. Or in Tsokatis meta-analysis, this cutoff is 12 kilopascal, again for ACV patient. Starting from 2015, European Association for the Study of the Liver Guideline recommend to use of this method for the evaluation of severity of fibrosis in this patient. And then it's now the normal practice in all the centers in Europe to use this elastographic method. But there are some points about transient elastography. This is quite difficult to be performed in obese patients, especially if you have only one probe, the M, you will be able to have results in only 70% of the cases. You must have both probe, XL and M probe. It's quite a blind method. It's not visible in patients with ascites, and it's quite a high cost for calibration of the probe, and this must be done in every year. Then we have other modality of evaluation, and these are other two shear elastography method, and this method are point and 2D shear elastography. For this both system are implemented in ultrasound machine, and then we can use this ultrasound machine for all others investigation like Doppler contrast enhanced or standard ultrasound, not only for elastography. And this system permit evaluation of patient with ascites that was not possible with FibroScan. And the results from the literature show good feasibility and a low maintenance cost of this machine. And which are these points? The first one, VTQ from Siemens on the market. Then there are ElastPQ from Philips, Hitachi, Samsung, SAOT, and others. 2D, the first one on the market was the Supersonic Explorer from Imaging for Explorer. And later on from GE, Philips, Canon, Samsung, and other systems have now inside their high-class machine this elastographic method. How to decide between these two methods, point or 2D? Point is more simple, maybe. It's easy to be performed, not ultrasound experience is necessary. We have a results in a number, it's a numeric method. Expression is made in kilopascal or meter per second, but the area of investigation is a small one, then it's 10 on 5 millimeter, and it's investigated in a point. For this is point shear elastography. For 2D or real-time shear elastography, this method is a color-coded and numeric. Then we have an image, colored image and numeric value. We have some criteria for the quality of acquisition in homogeneous area. but some experience in ultrasound is necessary to obtain the best standard ultrasound for the acquisition. The parameters, the characteristic parameters are something very important for the evaluation elastography, and transient elastography was the first that introduced this parameter IQR on median interquartile range, on median that must be below 30, and now it's used by all the machine like a qualitative parameter. But for 2D shear elastography, many companies propose supplemental qualitative parameter, and this make the ability to have a good quality image, and this qualitative criteria can be named confidence map, propagation map, RMI, or others. I will start with point shear elastography, and this in ultrasound machine can be performed in patient ascites, and virtual touch quantification was the first one, and this point and 2D use ARFI technology. For this, some people make confusion between in point shear elastography and ARFI. ARFI is the technology used for acquisition of the elastographic measurement. And now it's interesting in the practice because we have many meta-analyses that was published, and this was made in comparison with liver biopsy or with transient elastography. Point from VTQ is very simple, the box inside the liver, we are through the ribs in right lobe, at least 1 centimeter below the capsule. We have the same image for ElastPQ, the same box, at least 1 centimeter below the capsule. I present here one important meta-analysis made by Nierhoff in Germany, published some years ago in quite 4,000 patients. The AUROC for this point shear elastography VTQ was 0.84 for significant fibrosis, 0.89 for severe fibrosis, and 0.91 for liver cirrhosis. Then very good result for our daily practice. It's a paper of our group where we compare ElastPQ from Philips with transient elastography, and we found very good correlation between the two methods. And that finally, the correlation was R0.85 between the two methods. Then we have in the same time AUROC for ElastPQ in comparison with transient elastography 0.94 till 0.97. 2D shear elastography, it's a method again implemented into a sound machine. It's a numerical and color coded. There are now many papers that show the good value in practice, and now there are many systems that have inside the high-tech machine this 2D shear elastography system. It's an image of a 2D, then we have a color coded box where we can see that blue means no fibrosis, and we put inside a ROI, region of interest, and we obtain immediately a numeric value. Then we have color coded a numeric value. We have here another image from other machine. We have the box, the color is here, a mixture of color. We are somewhere here, then we know that it's a fibrosis. But the ROI give us the value 20 kilopascal, that means liver cirrhosis. Then we have two image, one of a color and second is of a number. Other system, we have a propagation map that show us the quality of our acquisition. And here the value is 13 kilopascal, then a liver cirrhosis. There are two papers published. One is wrote by Hermann in Germany, and it's a meta analysis in 1100 patients. And the AUROC for 2D shear elastography in ECV, HBV, and after the patient for signal fibrosis is 86, 90, and 85, and for cirrhosis for all three methods, for all three etiology is more than 90%. Then very good results. The same very good results for 2D shear elastography come from three meta-analyses. One is from Feng and 600 patients. And here in this meta-analysis, they found in the AUROC for F2 is 0.85, 0.93 for fibrosis 3, and 0.93 for fibrosis 4. Then for important, for significant fibrosis, the AUROC reach at least 0.85. There are two studies, interesting studies that compare transient elastography with point shear elastography and 2D in chronic hepatitis in comparison with liver biopsy, 349 patients in a multicenter French study, and find no significant difference between the method for diagnosis of mild fibrosis or cirrhosis. It's a study of Casinotto. And the same author made a multicentric study in NAFLD patient, again using the same system and in NAFLD patient. They use liver biopsy, and here the AUROC for the three method is here, from 0.86 to 0.77 for fibrosis 2, and this is increasing with the severity of fibrosis. And here for fibrosis 4, they are quite similar, the value for three method. Now something about the system that have inside the point and 2D in the same ultrasound machine. We speak here about the Samsung machine. Here is the point, very simple. We put the point, the box here, one at least 1 centimeter below the capsule, and here we put the big box and inside colored, and we put it here inside the region of interest. And we made here a study that we compare method, like reference method, transient elastography with point and 2D from Samsung RS85. And we use a reliability measurement is RMI. And this qualitative parameter is ideal to be near of one to be sure that we have a good acquisition. Here's the point from Samsung. Here's 2D from Samsung. And here we can have the value that we have here in our evaluation. What we found here in our published paper, we found the cutoff value for point shear elastography taking transient elastography like reference method, and this is for significant fibrosis, approximately 6 kilopascal. And for cirrhosis, 8 kilopascal, and the value for 2D shear elastography, 6.1 for fibrosis 2 or more, and 7.6 for fibrosis for cirrhosis. What we must have in mind in liver elastography, we must have in mind that every system have a different cutoff value, and we must know the cutoff value from the system that we have in our lab where we work with this system. And second, then there are in elastography some confounding factors that we must have in mind. The patient must be fasting. Second, the increased value of aminotransferases increase the value of elastographic measurement. Then we must be confident in value if the aminotransferases are less than 100 units. We must avoid the evaluation in obstructive jaundice, in important dry heart failure. All these increase the value of liver elastography. Then the question is what to use in practice, one or many elastographic method. We know that transient elastography was recommended by Easel. But in this moment, because we have a lot of paper and meta-analysis behind, point or 2D shear elastography are strong enough. We have enough paper behind that make us to be able to introduce this technique in our clinical practice. And this aspect are underlined in EFSUMB guideline that was published years ago. And in the next year, in 2018, the EFSUMB World Federation published again a guideline for liver ultrasound elastography. And this is the EFSUMB guideline. I will try to cover some points, some important points from this guideline for your daily practice. And what is important for this new guideline, because the first one was published in 13, this is in 17, the second guideline. And this cover all the shear wave elastography method, transient, point, and 2D shear wave elastography. On the other hand, show us that liver elastography using strain elastography of the liver is not ready for our daily practice, and make us a lot of recommendation for practice if we use this shear wave elastography. Recommendation one: the operator must be trained for liver elastography. Second, we must have a trained and special trained personnel for this purpose, and some experience is necessary for the use of elastography to obtain good results. How we perform this examination: the patient will be in supine and will use the intercostal space and the right arm in extension and during the breath hold of the patient. The measurement will be made by experienced operator, and for measurement in liver stiffness we'll use in point and 2D that have ultrasound image. The measurement will be made at least 10 millimeters below the capsule, because capsule must be avoided giving increased value. Something about fasting: a minimum 2 hours of fasting and a minimum 10 minutes of rest before the examination. And we must have in mind the confounding factor that I underlined in previous slide. And this must be avoided, because otherwise we'll have an overestimation of liver fibrosis. What we can have from shear wave elastography method? This shear wave elastography within the normal range can rule out significant liver fibrosis, and we can avoid and misdiagnosis of liver fibrosis. For transient elastography, there are some recommendations. Then first is 10 measurements will be obtained, and we must have some criteria that we use, like IQR median. The value obtained with XL probe are usually lower than the value obtained with M probe. For 2D, we must have a good quality acquisition of the image, that it's important to have good acquisition. And for point, we will make at least 10 measurements. And for 2D, a minimum of 3 measurements usually are enough. And for all these one, we'll use the median of this value and IQR on median that must be below 30. For strain, EFSUMB guidelines consider that in this moment, this method, strain elastography, is not recommended in clinical practice for evaluation of the liver. Something about examination from the skin for point and 2D. Usually we can put the box 4 or 5 centimeters below the surface of the liver of the skin, if we speak about the skin. And this is recommended when this is possible to be obtained. Something about chronic C hepatitis. Transient elastography is used like first-line modality of assessment of liver fibrosis in this patient. Point, as demonstrated with VTQ, can be used too for evaluation of ACV patient, but it performs best with regard to ruling out liver cirrhosis. For 2D, the results, they are especially with SSI. This was in the time of writing this paper, and this performed better with regard to ruling out liver cirrhosis. For follow-up of the patient, shearer-elastography is not recommended to be performed during the treatment, ACV treatment, but this method is recommended to be used for the follow-up of the patient. And if the patient is with a cirrhosis diagnosed by elastography before the treatment, then this surveillance will be continually during the life of this patient. Don't matter the value after the treatment. For HBV treatment, patient, transient elastography is useful for identification of liver cirrhosis. Be careful about the moment of the evaluation because the high value of aminotransferases can increase the value of elastography. And the second, transient can be used for the evaluation of inactive HBV carrier. For HBV, looking to point and 2D, we can use this method to identify the people with liver cirrhosis. For follow-up, it's important the value before the treatment, because the value before the treatment in the range of liver cirrhosis make the surveillance by ultrasound to be followed long life to have the chance to pick the small size ACC. In affluent patient with transient elastography, we can exclude the cirrhosis in affluent patient. In alcoholic liver disease, recommendation 27 have the main role to exclude cirrhosis in patients with alcoholic liver diseases, but we must be care about the flare that we can have during the acute alcoholic hepatitis. Looking to portal hypertension, transient elastography can be used for the assessment of portal hypertension, and there are enough papers showing these results, and this is included in Baveno 6 guideline. But for others method point and 2D, we must have more results to be sure about the use of this method for this one. Then, very simple conclusion. In this moment, the body of evidence show us that all these shearer elastographic methods are ready for their use in our daily practice. And this new guideline, EFSUMB new guideline, support all this reality. It's our group of people performing elastography, a lot of enthusiastic, young and enthusiastic people that helped me to work on this very nice field. And I finish with the invitation, hoping that the next year, 26-29 of May, we can have in Timișoara the World Congress of Ultrasound. And we invite you, all of you, to come in this meeting to have a lot of information about what is new in ultrasound field. Thank you very much.